I've come to the conclusion that I am personally gonna make the Model 2187 my most used weapon in Infinite Warfare. I don't have any particular reason why I'm doing that. I kinda just want to, because I like this shotgun and it gives me that old school Call of Duty feel. Well, as old school as you can get in Infinite Warfare. But anyway, guys, how are y'all doing today? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to talk about things that Infinite Warfare did right that I wish every other Call of Duty developer would carry over to their games. Now, this can be something small, it could be something huge, but regardless of that, everything that we talk about today is positive for our community, no matter what game it is in. You could be a good player, you could be a bad player. All of the things I talk about today affect every single person, no matter what era we're in either. So it could be future, it could be the past like World War II, and it could even be the present, just in case they go to Modern Warfare 4 when Infinity Ward rolls around their next game. But anyway, with that said, hope you guys enjoy the video. Let's get started. I noticed this very first thing on my list probably within the first 30 minutes of the Infinite Warfare beta, and ever since I've been thankful that Infinity Ward has added it, and that is relaxed player collision. Have you ever played a game like Black Ops 3, Advanced Warfare, and started running right behind a teammate only for them to stop in their tracks right in a doorway so you couldn't go around them and you had to find a new way to get to where you were going? Yeah. That happens a lot, and fortunately for us in Infinite Warfare, it doesn't happen at all. If a teammate stands in a doorway, you can actually phase through that teammate because of the relaxed player collision. So you don't have to worry about getting trapped in corners, you don't have to worry about not being able to go through a door that you are set on going through. That is one thing that literally changed the way that we play the game, and I'm happy that they added it to the game. Now, as of making this video, I noticed it wasn't in World War II, but maybe that will change moving forward. We'll have to wait and see. The next thing I want to bring up is actually in regard to the supply drop system, and for the sake of continuity in this video, I just want to reiterate it once again. Now, the biggest complaint from a lot of people in the community has been the supply drop system for the past few years, ever since it was introduced in Advanced Warfare. It is a no-brainer that Infinity Ward has handled this the best in their game, starting with how new weapons are introduced. Normally, when new weapons are introduced, you have to find them through a supply drop. And that can take forever. I know that there are still some people who are rank 1000 in Black Ops 3 and still don't have access to certain weapons like the nail gun or the PPSH. In Infinite Warfare, when a new weapon releases, you immediately get access to it if you have the season pass. If you don't, all you have to do is complete a simple challenge. That to me is 100% a game changer. I'm happy that they added that because now for content creators and of course people who may not have the best of luck in supply drops, we can make videos with these new weapons without having to worry about finding them in a randomly generated supply drop. Next up on the list, we would have to say, is the transferable currency between zombies and multiplayer. I couldn't tell you how many times I played zombies in Black Ops 3 and didn't give a single shit that I earned some liquid divinium. I used it, didn't get anything worthwhile, and really didn't care because I didn't play zombies as much as some other people out there. But I definitely think the transferable currency was a huge step in the right direction because now I can take those keys that I earn in zombies and use them in the multiplayer, or I can use them for zombie crates, or I can just continue to save them and not worry about a second form of currency and a second form of headaches. That to me was a good step in the right direction, and personally speaking, I hope if we can earn stuff in the third mode moving forward, it's all transferable like we saw in Infinite Warfare. Infinity Ward also did a pretty dang good job on variants and how you can earn them with the salvage system. I'm happy to go into the Quartermaster Collection, see everything that's available to me, and then make a decision on whether or not I want to use my salvage to get a specific variant or just completely forget about it and save my salvage. I still wish there were other ways to earn salvage, but beyond all that, that's pretty much all I want to take out of Infinite Warfare multiplayer. The connections are okay, they weren't like the best things ever, but I saw a lot less host migrations with this game. overall, it wasn't too incredibly bad. We're only at DLC 3 coming up in a couple of days here, but still, I wanted to talk about the things that are positive about this game that I've been noticing now that I've picked it back up after 4 months of just sitting on it. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video here today, make sure to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day by clicking that notification button as well and staying up to date on when I upload. Let me know down below in the comment section 5 things that you can take from Infinite Warfare that you actually like, that you would like to see integrated in future Call of Duty games. All right, guys, until tomorrow, I'll see ya. Peace.